Apart from that bravura bit in the third study, Chopin's fourth study is the first in which the left hand has to show equal agility to the right. It's kind of a competition between the two hands. There's one bar that's worth drawing attention to, this one. Note that there's a middle note or two that hang on for a fraction of a second. An inner voice. But note how the hand pivots around those notes in the middle, extending the range of the hand. This idea of an anchor in the middle around which the hand revolves is something very common in Chopin and certainly in Godofsky. The study is again marked very fast, presto, and for clarity's sake is best played without any pedal. To any pianist wanting to strengthen their left hand, I recommend a few months' hard labour on Godofsky's version of the fourth study. Here it's not a matter of the hands competing against each other, it's more a matter of the upper part of the hand competing against the lower part. At the beginning, it's the upper part. And a bit later, the lower part. Godofsky also gives us two versions of the opening music. When it comes as a reprise in the Chopin, it's exactly the same bars. But Godofsky gives us a lighter version, or relatively light, at the beginning. And when it comes back, it's heavier. This is pretty well a straight transcription of the fourth study, but it's not just a matter of cramming in as many notes into the left hand as possible and leaving out the ones that are totally impossible. Like any good transcriber, Godofsky absorbed the original study and then recreated it with a new set of rules, in this case, for left hand alone. It's still remarkable how much of the original study is contained in his version. An aside here, you might say, this is all very well as a study, just using one hand, but if we're judging it as a piece of music, why not use both hands and just make it easier? The answer is, apart from it being cheating, is that it's not the way the piece is designed. The more the right hand helps the left hand along, the more different it sounds and the less right it sounds. Here's an example. These bars I could play with two hands, which is easy. But for left hand alone, you can hear how different that sounds, and much more exciting. And even more exciting if you're watching the pianist attempt to do it. When you come to the coda in this study, which is quite different from the Chopin in a number of ways, it's just as brilliant, just as exciting as the Chopin. But because Godofsky is only allowing himself to use one hand, he was forced to be inventive and come up with some new ideas to make the passage or several bars possible. So there's a creative aspect if you're restricting yourself to writing just for one hand.